Hello, everybody. I'd like to apologize first off about the audio being missing from the last two videos that I made. That was my bad. I did not pre-listen to it and check it before I posted it. And a big thank you to the commenter who put me on to the fact that there was no audio. I never have made one that I know of, that I can think of, that I can remember, that had no audio. So if you ever see that, drop me a line. I may have forgot to check the video. That was a poor choice not to pre-watch it on my part. So this is a makeup video of the same two subjects from the same two sites. We're at the official supposed Illuminati website, like I was showing you before in the other video. This is www.illuminatiofficial.org. And you can find this little section here about their symbols and junk, and it'll bring up this book. And then you simply come down here and you open a book, and it tells you about their symbols. This is the pyramid. Now, the Illuminati is real. I want to make that perfectly clear. They are not fake. I was questioning whether this was an actual Illuminati site, because if they're a secret society with only the privileged elite Satanists, then it makes me wonder why it's on the internet. So this could be some just regular people who want to be Illuminati. I'm undecided. I'm kind of in the middle on it, but they are like the Freemasons in the sense that they don't deny that there is a God. It's just their choice of who they think is God. They think the devil is God, and that's who they worship. You know, they're talking about the I. Flip the page. They talk about the light. You can flip the page. And this is eternity. So they're talking about this symbol here. Eternal. The light, the eye, and the pyramid. And this is supposed to be the mark, according to these guys. So, that's what I was talking about in the last video, is they are all over the world. They're all inside our government. Masons and Illuminati, the old kissing cousins, whatever you want to call them. They infiltrated a long time ago. Working their plans, taking little baby steps. They have not been just ramming us headlong into things out in the open. Although they are way more overt now than before, but they gently push you, give you a nudge here and there, just nudge you over here the way they want you to go. We are in trying times right now. We're in a Shemitah year, followed by a Jubilee year. You cannot and should not believe what the economist in the mainstream news tells you about the economy. Because it's a joke. Yeah, they've created some jobs. Yeah, if you want to be a waiter or a waitress or work at Walmart or Kmart or Costco or Walgreens or McDonald's, if you want to be a maid at a motel, yeah, they've done all that. And that's if you count those as jobs, because that's the only thing you could possibly count. I mean, there is some different fields that have opened up, especially the energy sector with the oil field jobs. That's another thing. That is concocted. You read little snippets about it. It is all to punish. It is multi-pronged is what it is. It accomplishes that Israel, the Saudis, want to claim a bigger portion of the world market because they were slipping. And other people like the Harold Hams, the shale oil producers, were catching up with them and taking some of the pie. And they don't like to have as much pie taken from them as what was being taken. So they're trying to run them out. At the same time, it drops the price of the oil for sale to the nation that said no, you are lying. The Russians and Russia. They exposed who really used the chemical weapons whenever it was said somebody else did it. That dirty Assad. They exposed that it wasn't him. They said that they shot the airplane down. They produced some evidence that they did not. So they've been sticking it up Obama's rear end very hard, very deep at every turn that they tried to get their foothold over there in the Ukraine. And so the drop of the price is hurting their economy. The sanctions didn't hardly do nothing to them, but the price of the drop of the barrel in the world market is having an effect upon them. So it drags them down, and that's what they want to do. They want to make them irrelevant. They want to make them back off and get in the corner and have to worry about their own stuff so that they can get over there and do whatever they want. Rape, pillage, and plunder. Be in a different area of the world. That's why Biden had his son on that board of the energy company in the Ukraine. That was our little guy over there, all the way across the world. Yeah, taking orders from over here and making sure things are done the way they want. So you're going to see some things with the economy. Maybe the bucket doesn't drop all at once. But you're going to see it get some highs, because one only knows how it's reaching new highs. You know, the big players are putting money in, making some cash, taking a sale, taking the cash. Price goes down, they buy some more, yada, yada, yada. They keep repeating it, and they're making the money. That's how they do it. Us little guys, we make a little bit here and there. Nothing compared to them. So you're going to see it go way up, and there's going to be some days it's going to go down, and it's going to get to a point where there's more days it goes way down than what it can go up, and eventually it's going to significantly drop. Mark my words and see about that. I also spoke about CERN. I was mentioning that you couldn't hear that Pakistan has joined the group of nations that are involved in CERN now. The ideas of what they do in CERN can always start out as something good and meaningful, as HARP, the developer of HARP, did. But usually whenever you come up with a technology like that, they will take it over. And what was envisioned to be used for good ends up being used for everything but good, such as this: the key to unlocking dimensions. You know, if hell has some type of dimensional gate, maybe this is the key to the bottomless pit that unlocks that pit. They're going to be firing this baby up, giving her a good warm-up in March. I believe they're going to be full scale in May. It's going to have a tremendous amount of energy. I mean, compared to the last time before they shut it down and did their upgrades, it's, you know, whether they'll create a uncontrollable black hole this time, or maybe they think they've got the stones to and the know-how to be able to prevent the creation of a runaway black hole, whatnot. But they speak in here of, they speak in the description of this unit, and what it can do is it can possibly see into other, open other dimensions where there are other things in those dimensions. So obviously if there's other things in other dimensions, maybe they, as they open other dimensions, get into other dimensions, they let some stuff in, huh? Maybe they send some stuff through. Yeah, we have like an exchange program, huh? Here's some people, do what you want. Yeah, you guys can come on through into our world. Come on in here. They probably are stupid enough that they think that they've got the knowledge to control something that would come through. Because in the world of the Defense Department, this, in their eyes, would ultimately be used for some type of aggression, some type of weaponry, actually. High technology. They're not going to use it for the good of mankind. That ought to be pretty well agreeable to us all. They can say whatever they want to say about what they're going to use it for. But whenever it comes down to the nuts and bolts of things, they're going to use it for their own nefarious purposes and desires. And we, the little people, the meaningless ones, don't even factor into the equation of the people running this show. Because whoever's putting the money up, no matter what these scientists working on this want to do, they're going to do what the people with the money that's funding it all want them to do. The money people will dictate what this is for, what we're going to do with it, why we're actually doing it, what is it that we want out of it. That's going to be and is what the scope of it is. That's why it was built, funded, and is being used. And it just so happens, 2015 is going to be a big year for it. The whole world needs prayers. All we can get. We've got a bunch of stuff going on. We've got some French terrorists now. Call them what you may. I've said it all along. In antiquity, that's what it's been. Islam versus the faith in Christ. The faith in the I Am, the Creator, the real God. It's a battle in the unseen world, in the spirit world, another dimension. And it's a battle here. It's a battle above, as above, so below. We're fighting this fight everywhere. It's going to get worse before it gets better. So we have some really bad things coming in all ways that you can imagine. Climate, weather, financial, everything. So, you need to get in touch with Christ. And you need to know Him. You need to let Him be your strength. Because He wants to be. He wants you to call upon Him. He wants you to walk with Him. So I hope you have a beginning of the week that goes good and lasts all week long till the weekend time. I'll talk to you all soon.